Together again.
Good morning, Marmy. Welcome back to Mom Boss of Three. And look who's here. It's Taylor Kaye. It has been forever since I've done a mug moment. And there's gonna be a couple of them this month. But the first one is with Miss Taylor Kaye.
What?
If you're an OG member of the Marmy, you know who Taylor Kaye is. The last time we did a video together, I think was like 3 years ago.
It was, and that's, we met online because I found you online because I'm like,
she's stalking me.
I'm like, this mom is a hot mess with three, and I'm a hot mess. You've got three boys, I have three girls.
And that's it.
Boom.
That's how we became friends. I was thinking about it this morning. I'm like, one of the first videos we did was testing baby food. Do you remember that? We were taste testing.
That was the thing. People were doing these challenges.
The baby food challenge.
And then there was Tide Pods. We talked about it on the podcast, but we didn't really do it.
Yeah, we would never do that. We're not stupid.
No, exactly.
No, we're not.
I might do the baby food as a diet challenge.
Is that a real thing?
People do it. There's a guy at my work that actually eats baby food. I can't even look to lose weight. Because I guess it's all portioned. I can't do it. It's like,
it's portioned for a baby.
Right.
Okay.
Anyway, I digress.
All right. So today we had a whole different topic set up. And now I've decided that instead we're going to talk about annoying shit moms do to each other. But I think there's a top five here.
Okay.
There's top five. The first two are kind of related, but you know, whatever.
Okay.
Just for the sake of the title, top five. So number one, were you ever in a situation where, you know, you turned to a mom friend and you said,
Friend.
You turned to a mom friend and you said, my God, my kid is waking up every hour. And they responded with, that's nothing. My kid didn't sleep at all for the first 6 months of his life.
That's right. Why do they do that?
Belittling your experience.
Yes. Why are they you need to be part of the Marmy.
Mm-hmm. Mom Army.
Yes, yeah. Mom Army. Are those t-shirts still on sale?
Of course. Nice plug. Yes, yes. Why? Yes, they are. The link is in the description of this video.
So, but I mean, why do we have to belittle each other? Come on. Just stop.
And then there's like the not helpful people. So,
For example, you know who you are.
You know who you are. When you say to someone, oh, you know, my kid is not sleeping at all, and they're like, oh, my kid's been sleeping like through the night since they were 2 days old.
Since it came out of my vagina.
That's it, straight to bed.
Right?
Straight to bed. You're not helpful. They're not helpful.
They might have cradle cap, but they're sleeping through the night.
Exactly. And that's like their only goal. And the person just prides themselves on, like, my kid was sleeping, you know? Because I sleep trained them and did this. You cannot sleep train a 2-week-old kid.
I'm still sleep training my 7-year-old. There's no adult wrestling happening in my bedroom.
Oh my God, all the kids are just throughout the night, they end up in my bed. There's five of us and a king. It's like, it's like an art we've mastered.
Your room looks nice though, although we can't say anything.
We can't say anything about it, you'll see it soon.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
That's it, the not helpful mom. So that for me is actually really annoying because you're not providing any support to the person who's asking him anything.
No.
You're not being helpful, providing advice. You're just saying, oh, I never had that problem because my child is perfect.
It's perfect. And then you know these people because they're also in the Facebook groups because it's 3 a.m. We post this, I'll post it on a Facebook group going, God, help me with this, someone. And then people are, I'm like, come on, I'm in this group for help. I don't need any more judgment.
My God, the judgment, the mom judgment zone.
I know.
Facebook groups are the mom judgment
they
zone.
Are.
They
yes.
are. They are.
I know what I'm getting into. I'm like, shit, should I post that?
Okay, number three. And this one's a little bit iffy if your kids are really young. Canceling plans. I think that some moms, I don't really cancel plans, but some people are notorious, not just moms, but notorious for canceling plans. And for some moms, especially with the young kids, now we get it, poop explosion happens, there's no laundry, there's no clean socks, like shit happens. But like people cancel plans on someone to meet at the park or at like an indoor playground or something, it might be that mom's only time to get out.
And I get it because some people are like, okay, maybe they're going through something and that's why they're canceling. But you know what? No, you know that person. And it's always canceling. And then I'm like, then you want to be with them more. But you know they're going to cancel again. It's like your boyfriend. You're like, I got to spend time with them.
And oh my God, that's true.
And why
it's true. It's like a toxic relationship.
And finally you get your shit together. You're dressed. You're clean. Your boobs aren't leaking. The baby is in a clean outfit or at least you change them. And then canceled.
Canceled. Yeah, it's very hard. And sometimes it's hard to be alone all the time. That's another thing too.
Yeah.
So if you have friends that are like, you know, parents to like a newborn child or whatever, check in on them. If you have to cancel plans for any reason because you can't find clean socks, invite that mom to your house.
Yes, exactly.
Like, your house is a hot mess.
Change
it.
Fine. And you know what? This goes for moms. I will say I get canceled. People cancel on me all the time that don't have kids. And they have to understand it's a big deal for people with kids to go out.
Arrange the sun and moon.
Yes.
To watch the children, to make it to see you.
The stars need to align and they align.
Exactly.
You're like, yes, and then you cancel. Stop.
Yeah, yeah. You realize that you were that important.
Yes,
no
you
more.
Are important.
No more. Now you're canceled. So number four, mm-hmm. is talking smack about each other behind their each other's back.
I mean, I was just talking about Tina, like the other.
No, seriously though, like you have a group of friends, for example, you have a group of friends, right? And you know, maybe a friend is struggling with something, you know, and you're giving them advice. Like, so let's say it's sleep. We're always talking about sleep or poop, right? So sleep. Let's say you're struggling with sleep. You know, you've given them some advice and they've decided that that is not right for them. That's not how they want to do things, or it might not work in their house.
Yeah.
You need to kind of respect that a little bit, right?
You need to.
But instead of doing that and helping them find different strategies that might work, you go call up your next friend or open a next message in WhatsApp, and you're like, that's like, can you believe that she just won't even try this, you know, sleep training thing? She doesn't know what's going on. She's gonna be sorry. That's not gonna work. That's not helpful. That's toxic.
And your kids are watching, doesn't matter what age, so mm-hmm. they're learning from you. So if you're talking smack about someone, mm-hmm. they're learning, well, mommy has been doing this, or daddy.
Yeah.
So I think it's okay, I could do this at school. Now that I have a tween, I'm very careful. I don't do that because, mm-hmm. you know, and when she comes home to say, oh, I wanna talk about, I'm like, honey, let's talk about it here. Do not talk about it with your friends. Let's solve something here.
Yeah.
Right?
So we gotta preach kindness. Your kids learn what they see. Mm-hmm. So you can talk about a game, but if you're gonna turn around and start talking to your best friend, your girlfriend, telling her about like, oh, so-and-so is like a horrible mother.
Well,
like,
and someone has done, I will say, someone did that to me. This is about 6 months ago on WhatsApp, and the other person screenshot it and sent it to me. So remember, that stuff's online all the time.
It will bite you in
the mind. I guess if you are gonna do it on the phone, make sure you're not recorded.
Okay, so she's giving you strategies
but
to talk smack, just so you don't get caught.
Don't do it.
But don't do it, X-nay.
Don't talk smack.
Have to talk smack. The last one,
yes.
And this is one that I didn't think about, and Taylor brought it up, and it's totally true. How about one-upping each other?
Everybody, it's driving me crazy, and like, I hate, you know, you go to an event, you go to a party, or you go to a birthday party, and you're so proud that your kid made the soccer team or something, and then someone's like, oh, well, my kids made the triple, I don't even know, is it triple A, or even hockey or dance?
The Nationals.
The Nationals.
They play for the Maple Leafs.
So my kid dances and people are like, oh, my daughter goes to so-and-so. I'm like, because they want their kid to get to Juilliard. I'm just happy my kid might not be a stripper. I don't know.
And
if she
does, will not.
And if she does, she will be the best one because I'll one-up someone.
You know what, this is the most supportive mother I've ever seen. I mean, I will say freedom of choice, right? Like, it's...
And then I'll one-up you.
Yes, and then I'll one-up you. But my kid is the best stripper this side of the city.
In Canada.
Canada.
North America.
International.
Internationally. I just might strip just to end this video.
So we wanted to talk about 5 annoying things that moms do to each other in just a way of bringing it to light. Talk about this video with your friends. Be real about it. Let's stop doing this stuff to each other because moms feel left out. I feel like as a mom, sometimes I feel left out because there's the click, right?
It is the click. It is like that. It is. It
mean girls for moms.
Right.
Mean moms.
Mean moms. That
mean
is
moms.
It.
That should be our new show. We should have a reality show called Mean Moms.
It would be the best. It's like the Real Housewives.
But it's the real moms.
Mm-hmm.
The mean moms.
So I think people could add on to this below in the comments.
Yeah, let us know. What are some other annoying things that moms do to each other that you've noticed or that you want to see an end to or that you have a solution to? Anything, let us know in the comments down below. And as always, I hope you enjoyed today's video. And if you want to see Taylor again, let us know in the comments down below. Even if you don't want to see her, she's coming back.
I'll come back.
She's gonna come back.
There's free scones here.
I brought scones. So as always, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more videos, and follow me on my daily vlogs. Merch on, Marmy.